Hello everyone. Welcome to the lecture series of Engineering Mathematics 1. I am Sonali Gule. Today we are going to see a second unit of this lecture series, Engineering Mathematics 1, that is partial differentiation. So this is a second unit, partial differentiation, and you are welcome to the first lecture of this lecture series of partial differentiation. Here is the syllabus. These are the contents. Unit 2, partial differentiation, partial derivatives of first and higher orders, homogeneous functions, Euler's theorem for functions containing 2 and 3 variables. Here you have to write proofs also. Okay, total derivatives and change of variables. So these are the contents of this partial differentiation. Now, what is a partial differentiation? As you know, what is a derivative? It is a rate of change of a function with respect to, or rate of change of variable with respect to another variable, right? There was a function which was dependent on only a single variable. Now, here we are going to see a function which is dependent on more than one variable. So, there comes the concept of partial differentiation, okay? So let me show you here. Partial derivative. Let z is equal to f of xy be the function of two independent variables x and y if we keep y constant and find its derivative with respect to x, then it is called as partial derivative of z with respect to x, and it is denoted by dou z by dou x or dou f by dou x or fx of xy, etc. So these all are the notations of this partial derivative. Okay. Similarly, we can differentiate z with respect to y also by keeping x constant, because our z is a function of two variables, f of xy. Okay. Let me have an example here. Okay. Suppose we take an example of a rectangle, okay, and if I want to find the area of this rectangle, so we use the length and breadth concept. Area is what? Length into breadth, right? Now here, if I change the length of this rectangle, it changes the area. And if I change the breadth of this rectangle, it also changes the area. Means your area is depending on length as well as on breadth also, right? So that is a concept of dependency, where your function is depending on more than one variable, right? If I talk about the circle, okay, what is a circle area? It is given by pi r square, right? What is r? It is a radius, right? Now here this pi is a constant term, it doesn't change, but if I change the value of r, it changes area. Means your area is depending on only one variable, that is radius, right? So here comes the dependency of area on one variable. So if you observe these two examples, here the rectangle area depends on two variables and the area of circle depends on one variable. So whenever there is a dependency of single variable, then we find their total derivative, ordinary derivative. Okay. And when there is a concept of dependency of two variables, means your function is depending on two variables, then there comes a partial derivative. Okay. Now I hope the idea is clear about the partial derivative. Okay. Now here, some important results that I want to show you here. First of all, this result, dou by dou x. Now you have to remember one thing here. For partial derivative, we use the notation dou. Okay, this should be written like this only. Okay, you can't write it is like. This should be only like this. You have to use only this notation for partial differentiation. Now here, you can see dou by dou x into dou f upon dou x. Means if I take the double derivative of function, right? This is a derivative of function with respect to x. This is first order derivative, right? Now, if I take again a derivative of that function with respect to x, that is a double derivative. We can write it like this, okay? And also, I can write the notation fxx, okay? So, you have to remember all these notations for the double derivative, right? And I am taking a partial differentiation because our function is depending on more than one variable. So, here comes the notation dou for differentiation, okay? Now, the second result you can see here, dou upon dou y into dou f upon dou y. Means again already you have differentiated a function with respect to y and you are differentiating again it with respect to y. So, it is a double derivative of function with respect to y, dou to f upon dou y square, and also we can write it in the form fyy. That means a double derivative of function with respect to y. Okay, I hope you are getting a concept clear about the differentiation. First order derivative, second order derivative. Okay, just I am telling you here how we use the notations to represent the derivatives. Now here third concept. Now here you can see this inner derivative. It is a differentiation of function with respect to x. First order derivative with respect to x means its first derivative is with respect to x. And now I am differentiating a function with respect to y. Right? So here comes a double derivative of function. But it is now with respect to x and y. Both. Right? So here it is a double derivative of function with respect to x and y, which is again called a mixed derivative of function. And here we can write it fyx. Okay? Similarly, if I have already differentiated a function with respect to y and now I want to differentiate a function with respect to x, okay? So, I can write it is a double derivative of function with respect to x and y. Right? And here is the notation again, I can write fxy. Okay? Now, you can observe these two derivatives. We are differentiating a function with respect to x and y. Right? So, these two derivatives are same. Either you differentiate with respect to x and then with respect to y, or with respect to y and then with respect to x. Both the derivatives are same. Okay? And now last one that I told you right now here, both the derivatives are same. This is a property. You have to remember this. Okay? Now, next property we are going to see, it is for composite function. Composite function means here, if suppose here u is depending on r, means it is a function of r, and your r is depending on xy, means it is a function of x and y variable. Okay, then if I want to find a derivative of this u with respect to x, then I can find it directly because I don't have a dependency of u with respect to x directly. Okay, so here I have to use a chain rule for that. Means you can see if I want to differentiate u with respect to x, first of all I have to change its dependency. Means I'll differentiate u with respect to r first and then r with respect to x. That will give you the derivative of u with respect to x. Then next is u with respect to y. If I want to find, I will use the same concept. Okay, change the dependency. First of all, differentiate your u with respect to r and then your r with respect to y. So, that will give you the derivative of u with respect to y. Okay, you have to remember this chain rule also. This is very important. We are going to use it whenever there comes a concept of composite function. Okay. Now, direct partial differentiation. What is the direct partial differentiation? Here, you are given a function and you have to find its partial derivatives. That is the concept of direct partial differentiation. Okay? So, I am going to show you here with the help of example, how we solve the examples on the direct partial differentiation. So, here I am given a function u is equal to cos inverse x upon y. Now, you have to check here. U is depending on two variables, you know. What is it? X and y. Means dependency of u is on two variables. So whenever I differentiate u with respect to x, I have to take its partial derivative, and u with respect to y, it will be also partial derivative. Okay. So first of all, what I have to find? Derivative of u with respect to x. But as we all know, this is a function depending on two variable, right? It is depending on more than one variable. So there comes a concept of partial differentiation, right? So differentiate u with respect to x partially. Okay? So when I differentiate this u partially, what I get? I get here u with respect to x, that is a partial derivative of u, it is a notation, that is equal to differentiate a function cos inverse x upon y. Now while doing the differentiation, what I have to check? First of all, I have to find it derivative of cos inverse. Right? And I know the standard result. What is the differentiation of cos inverse x? It is minus 1 upon under root 1 minus x square. So, using this, I can differentiate this function 1 upon minus 1 upon under root 1 minus x upon y whole square. Right? Into, now differentiating this x upon y with respect to x, so 1 upon y is constant, right? Because with respect to x, y is constant, and differentiating x with respect to x, it is 1. Okay, so here we get the differentiation of u with respect to x, it is what? Minus 1 upon y into, now here I can solve 1 minus open bracket x square upon y square, okay, that is equals to minus 1 upon y into, what I can write now, cross multiply the terms, that will be y square minus x square. Now in denominator there comes the y square, okay, but this complete term is in square root, so I can write here u with respect to x is equal to minus 1 upon y into, now this term y square, it will come out from the square root and will go in numerator, right? So here I can write y upon under root y square minus x square, okay, that is equal to y get cancelled, minus 1 upon under root y square minus x square. So that is our differentiation of u with respect to x. I hope you understand how we can find a partial derivative of a given function. Now, what you have to do? Take this one as a homework. Differentiate this u now with respect to y. Okay? Next, hope you can solve the example that is given for homework. Yet, I want to show you here how I can solve it. So function is u is equal to cos inverse x upon y. Okay, now differentiating this u with respect to y partially. Now I am going to differentiate this u partially with respect to y. So this time x is constant. So here I can write u with respect to y, that is equal to dou by dou y of a function cos inverse x upon y. Okay, that is equal to, and I know the standard result of cos inverse x for differentiation, minus 1 upon, using that derivative I can write here 1 minus x upon y whole square. Okay, so again now I have to differentiate this x upon y with respect to y. Now this time x is constant and derivative of 1 upon y, it is minus 1 upon y square, right? So it is minus 1 upon, solve your denominator first, so that will be y square minus x square upon y square into minus x upon y square. Now this minus and this minus, it will be plus. So I will get here differentiation of u with respect to y. It is x upon y square under root y square minus x square. Now the term here, it is in denominator, that will go in numerator and taking its square root. So what I get here, into y. Now this y get cancelled. So what is the derivative of u with respect to y then? It is x upon y under root y square minus x square. So this is how we can find a partial differentiation of function given to us. Okay, I hope you all understood. Now next example is we are going to see here. So here it is our second example. If u is equal to e to the power r cos theta into cos r sin theta. This is a given function and we have to find the partial derivatives of u with respect to r and theta. Okay. Now see here. I am saying here it is a partial derivative again and again, because our function is depending on more than one variable. Right. So here also if you check, your function is depending on more than one variable. Right. Here you can see r and theta, there are in the functions. So what is the dependency here? U is depending on variable r and theta, right? Now first derivative we have to find with respect to r. So here we are going to differentiate u with respect to r partially. So all the time here I am writing partially, means you have to keep theta constant, right? So what is the derivative of u here with respect to r then? Okay, it is e to the power. Now see, here two functions are there. One is exponential and another is trigonometric, right? They are in product. So what I have to do? I have to use a product rule here for differentiation. So if suppose I keep e to the power r cos theta constant, right? And I take a derivative of this cos. I hope you all know the rule for differentiation, product rule. What is it? If suppose I am having a function which is in product, okay? So at that time, if suppose first of all I keep u constant, I have to differentiate v, okay? And now your v will be constant and I have to differentiate now u with respect to x. That is a product rule. So this rule I am going to use here. If suppose I consider this as u and this as v, I keep here u constant and now taking a derivative of v, means differentiation of this cos. And I know what is the derivative of cos. Yes, it is minus sine. Write down theta as it is. Okay. And now differentiating the theta with respect to r. So here r is constant and derivative of sine theta, it is cos theta. Okay. Now here plus, this time I have to put cos r sin theta constant, right? Now there is a little correction. We are differentiating function with respect to r. So when we differentiate this theta with respect to r, we have to keep sin theta constant and we have to take a derivative of r. So derivative of r is 1 and multiplied by sin theta. Okay. Now here, keeping cos r sin theta constant and taking a derivative of exponential function. We all know the derivative of exponential function is as it is. So it is e to the power r cos theta. And now differentiating this e to the power, power of this exponential term with respect to r. So cos theta is constant and derivative of r is 1. Okay. Now here, if you see this term and this term is common, I can keep outside. So e to the power r cos theta, it is outside. What is remaining here then? Minus sin theta into sin r sin theta plus cos theta into cos r sin theta. Okay. So this is our partial differentiation of u with respect to r. Similarly, now I can differentiate this function with respect to theta. Okay. By keeping r constant. So here, differentiate u with respect to theta, keeping r constant, means partially we have to differentiate the function. So now what is the derivative here then? U with respect to theta is equal to, now we are differentiating with respect to theta. Again I have to use a product rule because it is a function of exponential and trigonometric in product, right? So here, first of all, if suppose I keep this exponential term constant, e to the power r cos theta, and I take the derivative of this cos with respect to theta, okay? So here, derivative of cos, it is minus sin theta, and derivative of this r sin theta with respect to theta. Now here, r is constant and derivative of sin theta, it is cos theta, right? Plus, now keeping this exponential term constant and taking a derivative of this trigonometric function. Okay, so what is, this time now we have to keep this trigonometric function constant and we have to take a derivative of exponential function. So taking a derivative of exponential function, we all know it is as it is, and derivative of the power, now this time we are differentiating with respect to r. So r as it is, and differentiation of cos theta, it is minus sin theta. And the trigonometric term as it is, cos of r sin theta. Okay. And now simplifying the term, here I can find again e to the power r cos theta common. So what is remaining here then? Yes, minus r cos theta sin r sin theta plus, now here also minus sign is there, so I have to write minus r sin theta into cos r sin theta. That is a differentiation of u with respect to theta. So I hope you all understood how we can take a differentiation of function which is depending on more than one variable. Okay, now next example we are going to see here, that is our example 3. And here what we have to do, now these are the main examples starting that going to ask in your examination. Okay, so you have to concentrate here. Previously what examples I have taken, that two examples that are a basic examples how we can take a differentiation of a function, right? Now here these are the most important examples now onwards I am going to cover in this lecture and next lecture also. Okay, so here first of all write down your given function. What is it? U is equal to e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z. Now this is your given function. Okay, now you can check here your function is depending on three variables. There are three variables, x, y, z, means dependency of function is more than one variable. So when your function is depending on more than one variable, there comes the concept of partial differentiation. Okay, now what we have to show here, check, we have to show the partial derivative of u with respect to x plus partial derivative of u with respect to y plus partial derivative of u with respect to z is equal to 2u. We have to show this. So what we have to do, we are having a function and we have to differentiate this function with respect to x partially, then with respect to y partially, and then with respect to z partially. And after finding these all three partial derivatives, we have to add that together, and whatever is the answer, we have to show it is 2u. Okay, so let's start. So we have written already the given function. First of all, say this is an equation 1. Differentiate equation 1 with respect to x partially. Okay, now see, I am differentiating here function with respect to x partially, means another variables y and z are constant here. Okay, so you can see your xyz present in numerator and your xyz also present in denominator, means your function is present in numerator as well as in denominator. So when there is a concept of u by v, means there is a function of the form u by v, we have to use their rule of u by v. Okay, so I hope you all know the rule of that u by v. What is it? Yes, it is, if I am having a function u upon v, first of all your denominator is constant, taking a derivative of u minus, now numerator is constant, taking a denominator derivative of denominator, then divided by v square. So this is a formula for u by v. Okay, so here I have to use the same result to differentiate the term. So u with respect to x, first of all we have to take a derivative of numerator. Your denominator is constant, so write down the denominator as it is, e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z, right? And taking a derivative of this numerator, as it is an exponential term, write down it is as it is, e to the power x plus y plus z. And then derivative of this power, now there is a differentiation with respect to x, means y and z are constant. So when I take a derivative of this y and z with respect to x, that derivatives will be 0 and derivative of this x will be 1. So here I am going to write only 1. Okay, minus, now keeping your numerator constant and taking the derivative of this denominator. Now see, all these three exponential terms are separated. So if I take the derivative of these two terms, there is no x. Your y and z are constant. Means the derivative of this e to the power y and e to the power z with respect to x will be 0. Right? And we have to take a derivative of e to the power x only. So what is the derivative of this e to the power x then? Yes, it is e to the power x only. Right? Now, divided by v square. Now v square means this is your denominator v. You have to square the term. E to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. Okay? Now simplify the term. So if you see this term e to the power x plus y plus z and e to the power x plus y plus z. This is same. So I can keep outside e to the power x plus y plus z. Right? And in second bracket. What is the remaining then? Yes. These three terms e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z minus e to the power x. And denominator is what? Yes. E to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. So this is your derivative of u with respect to x. Now this e to the power x minus e to the power x will cancel. What is the remaining term then? E to the power x plus y plus z into e to the power y plus e to the power z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. Okay, so this is your differentiation of u with respect to x. Similarly now, can I differentiate this u with respect to y? Yes. I can differentiate this u with respect to z. If you see, when I differentiate u with respect to y, now variable is changing. Okay. Your x and z now constant if I differentiate with respect to y. Right? So what will be the differentiation of this u with respect to y? Yes. This time, when I differentiate here with respect to x, your change is here, e to the power x term is cancelled, right? So when I differentiate with respect to y, e to the power y term will be constant. And when I differentiate with respect to z, e to the power z term will cancel, right? So similarly now, next I can write, similarly, if I differentiate a function with respect to y, there is a change only e to the power x plus y plus z in bracket, as you can see here. Okay. Which term is cancelled? E to the power y. I am differentiating with respect to y, no? Okay. So here, now it comes e to the power x plus e to the power z. Divided by, what is the denominator here? You can see e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. So right here, e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. And the next derivative of u with respect to z. Now this term, which term is cancelled? E to the power z. Okay, so I can write here e to the power x plus y plus z into e to the power x plus e to the power y. Right? And now the denominator is e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. So these are our three partial derivatives of given function. Okay? Now see how I can write this two derivatives of u with respect to y and with respect to z similarly. Because if you take in numerator, function x, function y and function z having same form means x having degree 1, y having degree 1, z having degree 1, right? There is no constant multiplied with right? Same terms are there, only the variable is changed, right? Here also in denominator, e to the power x, e to the power y, e to the power z, same terms are there, okay? That's why we can write similarly the derivatives of u with respect to y and u with respect to z. Now, I got all the three derivatives and I have to prove now this. So, I am going to use the left hand side of this our proof. So, consider here, consider left hand side of the proof, what is it? U with respect to x plus u with respect to y plus u with respect to z. I have all the three values. Simply put all three values here. So, first of all, for this, e to the power x plus y plus z in bracket, e to the power, just a minute, here it should be e to the power y plus e to the power z, right, upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square plus, now the next is u with respect to y. So, e to the power x plus y plus z into e to the power x plus e to the power z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square plus, now for this u with respect to z, e to the power x plus y plus z into e to the power x plus e to the power y upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square, right? Now, if you observe this step here, these term, these and these, all these three are same, right? And also denominator is same. So, simply I can add the numerators. So, here taking the common terms outside, e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus y e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square. And what is remaining in bracket now? E to the power y plus e to the power z plus e to the power x plus e to the power z plus e to the power x plus e to the power y. And if you observe here, e to the power x plus e to the power x, it is 2 e to the power x, e to the power y plus e to the power y, it is 2 e to the power y, e to the power z plus e to the power z, it is 2 e to the power z. Means I can write here e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square, right? And if I write here 2 e to the power x plus 2 e to the power y plus 2 e to the power z. Now, taking 2 common from here, means now I get e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z whole square, right? And taking 2 common, e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z. So, this one term get cancelled. What is remaining? 2 e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z. But this term, e to the power x plus y plus z upon e to the power x plus e to the power y plus e to the power z. This is what? This is what our function given to us, you can see, right? So, therefore, I can replace here this term by u. So, I can write here 2 into u. And if you see the question here, what is our right hand side? It is 2u. So, I can write here, hence proved. Okay? So, I hope by using a direct partial differentiation, how we can show or how we can solve the given example. Okay, so let me explain you again. If you are having an example of this kind, where you have to use a partial derivative, suppose you are given like this a question and you have to show something, then you have to find the left hand side and show it is equal to right hand side. That is a concept here. Okay, let's solve one more example of the same kind. So this is our example 4 now. Here now I am given a function u is equal to log tan x plus tan y plus tan z, and then I have to show that sin 2x into dou u by dou x plus sin 2y into dou u by dou y plus sin 2z into dou u by dou z is equal to 2, right? So here also you can see you are having partial derivatives on your left hand side of the proof, right? Means what I have to do? I have to differentiate this function u with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z partially, right? So let's solve the example. So first of all, we have to write down a given part. What is given to us here? Yes, our function is u is equal to log of tan x plus tan y plus tan z, right? Now according to the proof, what I have to do? I have to differentiate u with respect to x, with respect to y, and with respect to z partially, right? So here, differentiate u with respect to x partially. So what I get then? Derivative of u with respect to x, that is equal to, now here I have to use the derivative of log, and I know what is the derivative of log x. Yes, it is 1 upon x using this differentiation. So instead of x, there is tan x, tan y, tan z. So I can write 1 upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z. But again, after using this derivative of log, I have to differentiate this tan x, tan y, tan z with respect to x, whatever is the function with log. Okay, so you have to multiply here by the derivative of these functions. Okay, now if you see tan y and tan z, there is no x, and these are constant functions with respect to x. So the derivative of this tan y and tan z will be 0. And what is the derivative of tan x? It is sec square x, right? Now doing an adjustment here. What adjustment I have to do? If you check your right hand side of the proof, for the derivative of u with respect to x, it is multiplied by sin 2x. So I am going to multiply this derivative by sin 2x. Okay? So multiply by sin 2x. So what I get here? Sin 2x dou u by dou x is equal to sin 2x upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z into sec square x. Now solving the right hand side of this, sin 2x, what I can write here? 2 sin x cos x. This is a formula for sin 2x. 2 sin x cos x into sec square x. Sec x I can write 1 upon cos x. So for sec square x, I can write here it is 1 upon cos square x. Write down your denominator as it is. It is tan x plus tan y plus tan z, right? Now, here one cos get cancelled. So sin x upon cos x, what I can write? Very good, it is 2 tan x upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z. So this is our value for sine 2x into dou u by dou x. So similarly, now we have to find all these derivatives of u with respect to y and with respect to z, right? Now, as I told you, for x it is a function of tan, for y it is also function of tan, for z it is also function of tan. All the three functions are same for x, y, z, right? So I can use here similarly. When I differentiate a function with respect to x, what I get here? Tan x, right? So if I differentiate this function with respect to y, which term I should get? Correct. I should get here, instead of tan x, tan y. And when I differentiate this u with respect to z, I'll get here tan z. Okay? So now I can write here similarly. I hope you all understanding. So here, similarly, if I am going to find this derivative with respect to y, sine 2y dou u by dou y. Okay, see here. This is a value of sine 2x dou u by dou x. So when I differentiate partially with respect to y and multiply by sine 2y, then I will get sine 2y dou u by dou y. Now here the change is only, instead of tan x, that should be tan y. Denominator will be same, tan x plus tan y plus tan z. Now writing for z, sine 2z dou u by dou z, and here comes, it is 2 tan z upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z. Okay, and now I can use a left hand side of the proof, because I am having all the three values now with me, right? So consider here our left hand side of the proof. Consider left hand side, what is it? Sine 2x dou u by dou x plus sine 2y dou u by dou y plus sine 2z dou u by dou z. That is our left hand side of the proof, right? Now putting your values of this sine 2x dou u by dou x, what is it? 2 tan x upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z plus 2 tan y upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z plus 2 tan z upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z. Now I hope you all understand. Now if you see here, denominator are same, right? So I can do the addition or subtraction of numerator if the denominator is same. So what I can write here? 2 tan x plus 2 tan y plus 2 tan z upon tan x plus tan y plus tan z. And I hope now you all understand what we have to do the next day. Very good. We have to find here 2 common and write down here 2 common, tan x plus tan y plus tan z, right? And now in denominator, it is again tan x plus tan y plus tan z. And these terms are going to cancel because they are same. So what is remaining here? Only 2. And if you see here, our quotient, what is on right hand side? It is 2. So just simply write down here, it is our required right hand side, hence proved. So I hope you all understand what we have to do. Yes, whenever we are having a question of this kind, we have to solve it by using left hand side equal to the right hand side. And to solve the left hand side, whatever the terms are required, what are the partial derivatives are required there, find it first and then use it in the left hand side and find your right hand side. Okay, so thank you all for watching this first lecture on this second unit. Now in next lecture we are going to continue with the same article, direct partial differentiation, and there we are going to have more examples on this. Okay, thank you all.